In Oklahoma, we're just months away from our first female governor. Jari Askins and Mary Fallin are vying for your votes. It was a dead heat lasting well into the night on the Democratic side, but Lieutenant Governor Jari Askins pulled out that win. Now, Eyewitness News 5's Mark Ockrand spoke to Askins shortly after finding out the good news. It's new this morning.
And of course, I'm joined now by the Democratic nominee for governor of Oklahoma, Jari Askins. Jari, how does it feel right now?
You know, it feels really gratifying. We worked hard. We felt like we had a good message to give to the people of Oklahoma. We knew from the beginning that it was going to be a tight race, but I feel very confident of what we were doing, and I'm just so grateful that our folks really went out and voted.
You said something interesting up there. You said you're not running to be the first woman governor. You're running to be the next governor of Oklahoma.
You know, I really think that this is an opportunity for this election, the general election, to be about qualifications, not about gender.
There's Jari Askins there, the Democratic nominee for governor. She will face Mary Fallin. Mark Ockrand, Eyewitness News 5.
Now, just moments before declaring victory, Askins got a phone call from her challenger, Attorney General Drew Edmondson, who conceded the race.
When you start off behind, you're likely to stay behind. So it wasn't very long when I thought the outcome was not going to be in my favor.
And Edmondson says that his political career at this point is over. He wants to spend his time in the private sector, and he says he'll be freshening up on his golf game. On the Republican side, Representative Mary Fallin sailed to a win, defeating three other candidates. We were there shortly after Fallin declared victory.
Matt Garcia here at the Mary Fallin victory party at the Will Rogers Theater. Fallin defeating State Senator Randy Brogdon in what turned out to be not a very close race. It was a wild day for Fallin that took her to Washington and back, where she didn't even get to vote for herself today.
I did miss voting for myself. I didn't get to vote for anybody because I had to leave really early this morning. It's kind of an emergency vote on funding for our troops. But I'm glad to be here tonight. It's fun to see all these people here. We're real excited to move Oklahoma forward and work on creating a more prosperous, better Oklahoma for our citizens.
But in the end, Mary Fallin becomes the Republican nominee for governor. Matt Garcia, Eyewitness News 5.
And we have all of these results posted on our website right now. There's a special election alert bar on the homepage of KOCO.com. You'll see it there, and you can check out everything from there.